Coming up on Oregon News, a Eugene man has been arrested for refusing rescue attempts while he was floating the Willamette River. And we'll tell you what EWEB is doing to prepare for the Cascadia earthquake. Good morning and welcome to Oregon News. I'm Spencer Herbus. The Supreme Court is divided on a decision again. Yesterday, President Obama's immigration plan left a tie in the Supreme Court. The plan would stop the deportation of millions of illegal immigrants who are already in the United States. With the death of Justice Scalia just a little over 2 months ago, the Supreme Court has only 8 justices, and this is the second time they have been split equally on an issue. The first was a decision on fees that workers would have to pay if they did not join a union. A 7.8 magnitude earthquake shook the coast of Ecuador this weekend. Officials say that there are at least 413 people dead and over 2,500 injured. Aftershocks of up to a 5.6 magnitude are still being felt in the surrounding areas. Ecuador has deployed 10,000 soldiers and 4,600 police officers to the damaged areas. Military has also brought in search dogs to help find people buried by rubble. Officials say preparing for an earthquake can significantly increase your chance of survival, and citizens of Eugene should be doing just that. The Cascadia earthquake, also known as the Big One, could hit any time between today and the next 50 years. However, the time to prepare is now. The Eugene Water and Electric Board is selling water jugs to customers to help people prepare. But that's not all EWEB is doing to prepare Lane County for this impending natural disaster.
For the past 6 years, EWEB has been in the process of retrofitting their facilities to meet higher seismic safety standards. Much of what is being done is simply adding extra reinforcement to the places of the building that will suffer the most structural damage when the shaking begins. Ray Leipold, a supervisor with EWEB, says the two main water basins are the most at risk. If reinforcements aren't strong enough, the basins would break, emptying out all the water in the treatment plant, and it would be impossible to refill them.
And we've already done some structural work to each one of these basins. We can see in the back here the pillars that were put up just last year was completed.
Even water sloshing back and forth due to the shaking is powerful enough to break down a cement wall. Steel beams have been added inside the building to increase stability. But the biggest issue is what will happen if the water is contaminated. Eugene's water supply comes from the Mackenzie River, and according to EWEB, Eugene is the only city in Oregon without a secondary water source. Although EWEB is expecting to turn the Willamette into a secondary source by 2022, they need to make sure they are ready in case the Willamette facility isn't finished in time.
Right now it's coming across those basins. Okay. By the end of this year, we will purchase our first mobile treatment unit, so essentially we can drive up to a river, lake, or puddle and treat the water in and distribute it.
Leipold says the best thing to be done is for everyone to prepare, not just as a city, but as individuals as well.
EWEB is expected to complete the retrofitting of their treatment facility by next year. Coming up after the break, we'll be taking a look at your weather forecast for the rest of this week. Stay tuned.
Start a story. Adopt at the
A Eugene man has been arrested for resisting rescue attempts by the Eugene Police Department while floating the Willamette River. Police identified the man as Charles Eugene Miller. Officers responded to a 911 call on Sunday afternoon reporting a man floating past Maury Jacobs Park. The call came from a man on a jet ski who attempted to rescue Miller, but Miller repeatedly broke free from the caller's grasp. Upon arriving at the scene, emergency responders tried to rescue Miller. After he resisted, they had to forcefully grab him and pin him to a rescue boat. Miller was taken to the hospital before being escorted to the Lane County Jail, where he's being charged with harassment, second-degree criminal trespass, interfering with a police officer, and disorderly conduct. And now for your weekly weather forecast. Enjoy these last couple of days of beautiful weather because those April showers are expected to hit hard this weekend. In Eugene, we'll be seeing some partly cloudy skies today and tomorrow, but rain clouds will be rolling in on Friday. Temperatures will be at a high of 83 today, 74 tomorrow, and 72 on Thursday. This weekend, we'll stay in the low 60s. Portland is looking similar with mostly sunny skies tomorrow, but an 80% chance of rain on Friday and throughout the rest of the weekend. A high of 86 tomorrow, 77 on Wednesday, and lows in the mid to low 50s. That's all we have for you today. Thanks for joining us this morning on Oregon News. We'll see you back here tomorrow.